of the storm, you remain in control. And in the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor when my sails are torn. Your love surrounds me in the eye of the storm. When the solid ground is falling now from underneath my feet, between the black skies and my red eyes, I can barely see. When I realize I've been sold out by my friends and my family, I can feel the rain reminding me. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. See the future I picture slowly fade away. And when the tears of pain and heartache are pouring down my face, I find my peace in Jesus' name. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul.
Amen. Well, this is Evangelist Ratia Rogers with Ratia Rogers Evangelism Ministries. And we go out to be a blessing every single month for the homeless, the women in Turley, the senior citizens, and we're reaching out to the youth. So I'm about to go into this message, and I pray that it is a blessing to you. Reach out to us. God bless you. Amen. This message is entitled, The Combo Prayer. Amen. James 5:16, The Combo Prayer. Hallelujah. James 5:16. I'm going to go right into prayer. Lord, in Jesus' name, I thank you, God, for today. I thank you, Lord, that you're teaching your people how to pray. Amen. Where they can get addicted to praying. Amen. Make prayer a habit in their life. I ask you to touch, move, pull out, put in. Whatever needs to be done, Holy Spirit, come right now in Jesus' name. Bless the people, God. I thank you for using me as a vessel to deliver your message, God. I thank you, Lord, according to your word found in James 5:16. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. James 5:16, amen. The combo prayer. Hallelujah. Confess your sins to each other and pray for each other, so that you may be healed. The earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. Elijah was as human as we are, and yet when he prayed earnestly that no rain would fall, and none fell for 3.5 years. Then when he prayed again, the sky sent down rain, and the earth began to yield its crops. Amen. Glory to God. Confess your sins to each other. That means when things go on, amen, when ungodly things take place, amen, we have to confess our sins. We have to say, I'm sorry. My bad. I'm sorry. Forgive me. Amen. Because we're human and we're going to do some mess ups. Amen. We're going to make some mistakes. But the Bible is so careful to teach us about confess your sins to each other. I apologize. I'm sorry. My bad. I messed up. Forgive me. Amen. Just as God forgives us, he wants us to forgive one another. The earnest prayers of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. Amen. Amen. When you're earnest, this is sincere. It's heartfelt. You mean it. Amen. The earnest prayer of a righteous person, a person that is right standing with God. Amen. God can work wonders and miracles, is what the Bible is saying, can produce wonderful results. Hallelujah. Just like Elijah, amen, just like you, amen. When you ask God to do something, God's going to do it, amen. God combo prayer, and it goes hand in hand. That when you confess your sins and when you pray, and then, see, right here in my Bible, it says that when you confess your sins to each other, pray for each other, so that you may be healed. The Bible is teaching us, amen, right here, but God is the one that heals. So God wants to bring healing to your life, because it says the earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power, amen, has great pull, amen, has great pull, amen, hallelujah, pull it down from the heavens. It produces wonderful results, amen. It can happen because the Bible says so, and it used Elijah, amen, as an example to show us, amen. It says Elijah was as human just as we are, just as I am, just as you are, amen. And it says, and then when he prayed, the Bible says earnestly that no rain would fall, none fell for 3.5 years. And then the Bible says when he prayed again, and then God, amen, caused the blessings to come down of rain in abundance. Hallelujah. So when you confess your sins, amen, then you can bring healing. And then once healing is brought forth, it says that, which means you're in right standing with God. You're in right standing with God. Amen. When you do that. So when you do that, you can produce, your prayers are powerful. You're going to have powerful prayers. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The combo prayer. It goes hand in hand, which means that you can't do one without the other. Amen. It goes together. It's together. Amen. You know, like the combo meal, amen, you got a hamburger or a cheeseburger, and it comes with french fries, amen? Yes, or you get a steak and it comes with mashed potatoes. It goes hand in hand. It's the combo prayer, amen? Your prayers push. Your prayers do push. Hallelujah. Confess your sins to each other. Talk it over. Say, I'm sorry. I didn't mean that, amen? You can't hold on to it, amen? Because if you want to produce wonders, amen, in your prayers, then we got to let go. And the Bible calls that being healed. Confess your sins so that you can be healed, amen? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You know, I remember a long time ago, I was facing something, you know, a situation had come up against me with someone else, and, you know, I'm a believer. I'm a Christian, so I already know how that goes. So I had to forgive. You know, you got to take it up to God and pray and forgive and just let it go. Amen? Because God is the one that works on the inside of the hearts. Hallelujah. Confess your sins. Confess your sins to each other and pray. We got to go. We got to confess it. We got to say something about it. I'm sorry. We just can't let it be. We got to talk it over. Amen? But some people, you may not be able to go up to them and say, I'm sorry, amen? But you can go to God and tell God that you're sorry that that situation had came up. You can simply go to God and ask God to forgive you. Ask God to forgive them, amen? You can simply go to God because the Bible says to confess, amen? Confess is something that you have to open up your mouth and do. Confess your faults to each other. Confess your sins. Confess your mess ups, amen? And then that's when the healing, Jesus came to bring healing in our life. That's when the healing comes. So then when you go to God in prayer, amen, it says the earnest prayer of a righteous person that's right standing with God, it produces wonders. Amen. It produces wonders. Hallelujah. So we want to be so careful to know to confess it, pray, we got to forgive so that the healing can start taking effect, so that the healing can take place. In order to have powerful prayers, this is a combo, amen? This go hand in hand. In order to have your prayers answered, amen? In order for God to do exceedingly, in order for God to do abundant and big things, this go hand in hand. It's the combo prayer. Hallelujah. So we want to be sure to confess it. Confess your sins and pray for people. Amen. Pray for them. because they messed up, and I'm sure it wasn't their first time, just like it wasn't your first time, amen? So when you go to God in prayer, amen, for the ones that you just can't, they just dislike you no matter what. So when you messed up, or you made that little bitty mistake, it turned it up for them, amen? It turned it up even more for them not to like you, because they already didn't like you. Then when you did the least little thing, it put the icing on the cake, amen? So for those people, then, you know, in order to avoid strife from that, in order to avoid a fight, you can take it up to God and mean it from the bottom of your heart. God, I'm sorry. Pray about the situation to God, amen? But for the ones that you can go up to and you can sit down and you can talk about it and give a hug later, amen? And give a hug, God is saying that those prayers are earnest, and that God can pop up. God can show up and do exceedingly and abundantly. God can do, God says that those prayers will produce the righteous prayers, it will produce. The earnest prayers of a righteous person, the Bible says that it has great power, and it's gonna bring wonders. It's gonna bring you wonderful results when you do that, when you follow up with what the Bible says. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We just want to be thankful to God because, you know, He is the forgiver of sins, and we just want to be so thankful to God that He does that, and that He teaches us how to follow Him, how to be His disciples, how to be His ambassadors, how to follow Jesus, amen, because Jesus, amen, he did it, amen, He still forgives today. Confess your sins to each other and pray. Pray for each other so that you can be healed, so that you can be healed, so that you can bring healing in that area, so that you can bring healing in that situation, amen. You can bring the healing, amen, because you're doing what God told you to do. So therefore, God has to do, because, you know, He has to follow up with His word. The Bible also says that God's word does not come back void. It is sent forth to go out and do what? To go and accomplish what the Bible sent it out, what the Bible sent the word out to go and to do. It's going to take place. It's going to take an effect, amen? We have to follow what step one, step two, step three. We have to follow the instructions out of the Bible. So it says first, to confess it, and you pray. Pray for her, pray for him, pray for them, pray for that job. You got to pray, amen? And then God will come through and bring the healing in that allegation for you, because you're following the steps and you're doing exactly what God said to do. Hallelujah. The earnest prayers of a righteous person is going to cause God to come and bring a healing of deliverance for you, for your heart, for their heart, for the whole entire situation. Amen. God, he wants to do it. He's here. He wants to do it. Amen. So push your prayers. Amen. Your prayers is being pushed. Amen. Your prayers are being pushed up towards God when you follow these instructions. The earnest prayer of a righteous person is going to cause God to come on the scene and to take out whatever needs to be taken out and to put in. Amen. God is the one that does the mending. God is the one that can put it all back together again. God, He is the one. Amen. He's the faithful one. He's the Holy One of Israel. Amen. He is the faithful one. He's the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. Amen. He is your King of glory. Amen. He is your God that does the forgiving. Amen. He's the God that reminds you to forgive. Amen. And not hold on to that on the inside of your heart. God is saying to release that. Get it out. Amen. Confess your sins and pray. God wants you to confess. And then the Bible says that there's a word. There's a three-letter word. It says, and pray. Confess and pray. You want to say that with me? Confess and pray. Confess it and pray. Confess it and then you can pray. Amen. Not pray. Amen. And then confess it. God says, come to Him first and say, God, talk to God about it. God, I'm sorry. I confess it. And then God is listening to your prayers because there's so much stuff that you haven't even saw yet. There's stuff that's on the way. Amen. Repeat after me. Say, stuff, blessings, it's on its way. Come on. Stuff, blessings, is on its way in my life. Amen. Because you're doing what the Bible said to do. Confess it and then pray. Pray for who? Pray for that person. Pray for those people to where this situation came out to be. So then you can be healed. Then Jesus, Jehovah Rapha, can bring the healing and the mending. Amen. The earnest prayers of a righteous or a right-standing individual or person, amen, it's going to cause God to bring wonderful and powerful results through your prayers, amen, through your prayers to God. This is the combo. You got to know that it goes hand in hand. It goes together, amen. So we want to be so careful to know that just like the Bible uses Elijah as an example, it says that he was as human as we are. Yet when he prayed, amen, he saw the big wonders from God. He asked God, amen, and God did it, amen. He stopped the rain, and then the Bible says, then when he prayed again, and then God, he brought down the rain. Amen. God, he brought it down. So God is using that to teach you that there's an example right there that God can stop something just for you. Mm-hmm. God can stop something just for you. And then he can cause it to happen again because of your prayers. Uh-huh. Just for you. God can do just that. So when we follow and apply this, confess your sins, talk about it, and pray. Amen. Take it up to God through your prayers. Amen. So God, he can heal. God wants to heal that. You've been hurt. You know, there's a situation that you've been facing within your own family, within your own blood relatives. There's some hate there. There's some envy. There's some jealousy. There's all kind of devilish things. Amen. But you got to be the bigger one if you want to see God. If you really want to see God move in a miraculous way, if you really want to see God do this, do what he said he's going to do, then you have to take him at his word and do exactly of how he said to do it. Amen. God can transform and turn everything around. See, what the enemy meant for bad or meant for evil, God can turn around and produce what's good. God can bring good and potent, powerful results through your prayers. But you have to follow God's system. Amen. You have to follow the system of the living God. Amen. Confess it. Pray. And allow God to put it together. Allow God to take out whatever needs to be taken out and to put it in, because he is the only one. You see, you've been trying to fix it, but God, he wants you to know that he's the only one that can fix that. He is the only one. So you better believe it, that God is the only one that can fix it. But you have to follow God's rules, God's words, God's ways, so that you can see his will. Amen. Take place. Amen. The combo prayer, it goes hand in hand. We have to follow and apply it. Amen. We have to confess what's wrong. Come on now. And pray. Uh-huh. And then God will bring the healing. So then when you're talking to God in prayer, then he can cause powerful and exponential expedited things to happen, to fall down upon you in your life. Amen. Glory to God. Bless his name. That's right. Bless his name right now. Thank you, God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for moving, God. Just thank God right where you are. Say, thank you, God. If you need to cry, let it out. Thank you, God, for moving, God. Thank you for rearranging things in my life. Tell that to God. Say, God, I thank you. God, I thank you for changing. I thank you for rearranging. I thank you for turning it all the way around. Amen. 180. Turning it all the way around. I give it to you, God. Help me be the bigger person. That's right. Talk to God. Tell him. He will give you the strength. And he will tell you exactly what to do. Amen. You're not going to go in with strife. And you're not going to go in being the one that wants to talk more than the other one and shut the other one out. But come on. You're going to go in with peace. You're going to go in following what the scriptures told you to follow. What the Bible said to do. So God can do it. But you have to do first. First of all, you have to do what God said to do. If you really want to see healing, then you got to do what God said. You just simply have to go out and do what he said to do regarding the situation. And there's lots of things going on. You know, this person may have this type of situation. This one over here totally different. But, you know, we have to do, regardless of what the situation is, the Bible says to confess. Confess. Amen. Go. These are your, they love you. You love them. But somehow, you guys allow it, the devil, the enemy, to come in and to keep you apart with all these lies and all of this backbiting and this talking. Amen. Back and forth. God is saying to confess. Just confess. And he's going to heal you in your heart. He's going to heal you because he wants to use you. He wants to use you for his glory, amen, to be displayed upon the face of this earth, amen, hallelujah. So you got to know to confess, you got to pray, take it to God in prayer, confess, God, I'm sorry, I messed up, forgive me, God, help me to forgive them, forgive all of them, God, it's okay, this has been driving me crazy for a long time, and that's what God wants you to do. He wants you to say what I just said. Say that to God. Say, God has been driving me down the wall for a long time. And today, I come clean. I come clean. I forgive them, God. Heal my heart. Talk to God. Say that. Amen. Hallelujah. If you don't know what else to say, just say what I'm saying. Amen. Say what I'm saying. Say, God, I'm sorry. I come to you. I forgive them. Forgive me, God. God is going to bless you. That's right. You've been praying and you've been asking God for that thing. And the reason why you haven't saw it yet is because you got to get the mess or all that hatred and strife stuff out of your heart. You got to get it out because Jesus Christ is the healer. It says, after you confess and pray, and then you can be healed. God will bring the healing. He said so. God, he will bring the healing. He will put it all back together again. And he will cause your prayers, amen, to be potent, to be powerful, potent, powerful prayers to God. And he's going to bless you. And even, you know, and even if you just stand up and you do what the Bible is instructing you to do, and those other people say they just never did it. God, you know, God is going to put a double blessing on you. Amen. You, because you did what he said to do. Amen. And you praying, and they just say they never did it. Amen. I know some people, amen, and some things that happened in my life. Amen. That I know that I am a lover of God, that I am my prayers are powerful, amen, but there's just some people that they're blinded by the devil. They are so blinded by Satan that they just will never, they'll after that one mess up or mistake happened, they'll just treat you like that for the seems like the rest of their life. If they don't want change. So now I know there's situations and circumstances. I may be speaking to you today, and you've already done that. You've already done what I'm ministering to you about, amen? And the other person just hadn't come through. You know, there was a situation a long time ago with someone that was treating me like that, or dealing with me, amen? And I prayed, and I speak, and I smile, amen? And the other person just wouldn't do it. But you know what? The other person wouldn't do it for a long time. I mean, a long time. But I kept praying and, you know, doing my thing, smile, hello, you know. And then all of a sudden, one day, wow, it changed. So I just, you know, that's something to thank God about. You know, thank God for that other person. The other person don't have to continue living in darkness, you know, over something small or big. Amen. Because we want our prayers to produce wonders. Amen. God is going to cause your prayers to produce, amen, wonderful prayers, amen, powerful prayers, when you follow the God kind of system that I'm talking about, amen, the God kind of system, this is for you. So we have to know to confess it, pray about it. God is going to do the healing. So then when you pray, the Bible says, the earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. Amen. Anybody would love to see wonderful results or wonders in their prayers, in their powerful prayers. Amen. But there's a system. You have to follow God's ways. You have to follow God's system because this is the combo prayer. See, when you do what God said to do and when you pray, then God, he's got to show up. He has got to show up on the scene, amen, to turn it around, to turn around your situation. God, he's got to show up. He's going to show up just like he did mine, amen. There's countless of different stories and things I can testify about God, the goodness of God, amen. But God is using me today, amen, to minister to your heart, amen, so that you can be released. You can be loosed. Be loosed, my brother. Be loose, my sister, in the name of Jesus. I'm going to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that your people will be loose in the name of Jesus. I pray against you, Satan. I bind you. Therefore, you are bound in the heavens. God, I loose your angelic host over your people, God, and that they will confess, God, so that you can do the healing. So when they pray, you can show up and do wonders in their prayer life, God. God bless your people. I thank you for them. I thank you for your word, God, that goes. Your word is effective, God. I thank you right now in the matchless name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so at this time, I'm going to pray for you. If you never accepted Jesus, we're going to do two prayers. And the other one is if you need to come back, if you need to run back. So just simply repeat after me. Amen. It's okay. Amen. God wants you. Amen. The devil done used you up, and God, he wants you. He wants your soul. Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, I come to you. I believe that God raised Jesus from the dead. I ask you to come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. Use me, God. Use me. I trust you. I love you. I thank you, God, for doing a mighty work in my life. I love you. I thank you. Bless my family, God. Give us peace. In Jesus' name, amen. So if you pray that prayer, you are saved. Amen. And if you need to come back, just repeat after me. Father, in Jesus' name, I run back to you, God. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus, for your word, God. I run back to you, God. I thank you, Lord. Forgive me, God, for running away from you, God. I know that I needed you, God. I'm back, God. Help me. Heal me. Bless me, God. I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. So I thank you for tuning in. I thank you for listening. And if this message has touched you or impacted you or inspired you, visit us at rreministries.org. Sow a seed online. Bless us. And we already know that those who bless this ministry, God is going to get in it, and God will bless you. Amen. Amen.
We would like to invite you to Harvest Time Prayer Ministry, Bible College, and Intercessory Prayer. We meet every Tuesday night at 6:30 p.m. at 844 East 46th Street North, right here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I would like to introduce you to a former student. This student is Evangelist Ratia Rogers. Ratia was a student for 2 years at Harvest Time Bible College. She is a student of excellence. She has a teachable spirit. She was faithful every Tuesday for 2 years. She served 1 year as the Bible College student president, which she did an awesome job with that. And we have really good teaching, good teachers. We stay with the Word of God. We don't go any further than the Word. And we have a witness here, this wonderful woman of God, this woman of excellence, this woman who loves Jesus, this woman who's going forth in the ministry and doing the work of Christ. So come and join us as our mission is to raise up intercessors and spirit-led leaders. Thank you.